I'd say that mine is pretty short, but thick, and sometimes textured. I'm talking about hair, people. Hey there, hairy humans. Trace here for DNews. There are so many different types of hair. Wavy, straight, fine, thin, thick, curly, bushy, wiry. Some people's hair is easy to comb, while others is constantly a tangled mess. But is there really an advantage to having a certain type of hair? We've talked a bit about why we have hair at all in another DNews video, you can watch that, but needless to say, we have it. Fur and hair, it's the same thing. All mammals have hair, including us. Hair is composed of keratin, a fibrous, resilient protein that gives hair its strength. The keratin protein is made up of long chains of amino acids bonded together, the most abundant of which is cysteine, which is able to form strong bonds with itself called disulfide bonds. That's important because where these bonds accumulate on the hair shaft influences the shape of the hair. For example, in curly hair, the protein builds up more on one side of the hair, causing it to curve, whereas in straight hair, it's distributed more evenly throughout. There's even a condition called uncombable hair syndrome, involving a gene mutation that doesn't allow keratin to bond to the hair shaft correctly, causing extremely dry, frizzy hair and endless tangles. But keratin isn't the only thing that changes hair type. The shape of the hair follicles, the structures that your skin actually grows hair out of, influence its shape and thickness. Larger follicles produce thicker strands of hair, smaller follicles, thinner strands. Makes sense. But if the follicles are, say, oval-shaped or asymmetrical, then the hair that comes out of them won't be perfectly round. Instead, it will bend to one side, producing curls. Think about it like gift wrapping ribbon. When you run scissors along one side of the ribbon, it will curl. It's a similar principle with an asymmetrical follicle. One side is flat and the other is curved, resulting in ringlets. Frizz and texture are often associated with curly hair because natural oils secreted by your scalp can't move down the hair as easily. Those oils trap moisture in the hair, which is why humidity makes curly hair even more frizzy. But there's definitely one advantage of having curly hair, and it's not what you think. Curly hair actually tangles less than straight hair. Yeah, a study published in the American Journal of Physics found that the angle at which straight hairs bump into each other is most likely to cause tangling. See, the outside of your hair shaft, called the cuticle, consists of a series of overlapping keratin cells, like shingles on a roof. If the hairs meet at a sharp angle, the cuticles can hook onto each other. Although straight hairs meet less often than curly hairs overall, when they do, they tend to meet at steeper angles and thus are more likely to hook and tangle than curly hairs. We all have different hair, but there's not a hard evolutionary reason why, though there are a bunch of hypotheses as to how we got it. Like one 2013 study in the journal Cell, which found a specific gene mutation that causes thicker hair. It emerged 30,000 years ago in central China, later spreading to Africa and Europe. That same gene mutation also had other effects, such as increasing the density of sweat glands. The researchers believe that high humidity in East Asia at the time may have given people with this mutation an advantage because they could sweat more efficiently, and perhaps thicker hair simply propagated as a side effect of that mutation. Another study in the American Journal of Human Genetics identified two genes which cause curly hair in European descendants, but even they say the exact point when curly hair evolved is unknown. More research is obviously needed to see what other factors could be involved. But whether you've got stick straight strands or corkscrew curls, hair is completely individual. So embrace what nature gave you, and remember, it's the size of the follicle that matters. I hated my hair for a long time until I figured out how to take care of it. It was definitely a process, but now I love it, or what's left of it. You want to know more about hair? Here are 5 weird uses for it, besides just keeping your head warm. Also, check out this video from our friends at Secret Stories about how professional actors are teaching medical students how to interact with patients. Got any hair tips? Tell us in the comments. Please subscribe for more DNews, and thanks for watching.